when people like on the phone they tell me, oh hello mister, it always like gives us like a little spark or something. Me, like my identity as being trans, I'm just so proud of it that I wanted like maybe shout it out of the roofs, because I can conquer everything, I guess. So I'm Sane. I identify as a man, a transgender man actually. Being transgender means that you identify differently with the gender you were assigned at birth. You have two types of transition. You have social transition and medical transition. For most of trans people, they do like the social transition. That means if you're a trans man, you start to live as a man. And like the medical transition is like, yeah, the real medical steps you need to take, like hormone therapy, some operations you can do. But not all trans people do these medical steps. So I started taking testosterone on the 8th of August 2017, so a year and a half right now. And from that moment, yeah, it helped me to be the man I needed to be, and like other people to see me as the man I am. So yeah, to me that date is like very, very important.
Many patients who come for hormone treatment, somehow they're still kind of worried, and together with them, their families and also maybe their GPs or other doctors, that hormone treatment will induce something bad, that they will have more cardiovascular disease, that they will have more hormone-related cancers.
Yeah, so I guess I don't want to think about it a lot, because if I would, it would be some kind of nerve-wracking, because yeah, I have no idea what this hormone will do to my body.
When I finished my PhD, what you found in the literature was small case series, a lot of opinions, a lot of expert opinion papers, but very little well-structured research. So with the study that we are conducting now, we set out to look for the longer-term effects and side effects of hormone treatment in trans people. And what we found is that people are doing very well. Do people have side effects? Do you see anything in the blood that goes wrong? And in fact, I really have to do an effort to find anything that goes wrong in those blood results. And we've documented that on a very large number of patients now. There are still quite a lot of colleagues who are opposed to hormone treatment in trans people. And I just want to show with my research that hormonal treatment in trans people is not very difficult, that it helps your patients a lot, that they really need it. So I want to break down their arguments one by one. And hopefully more of my colleagues will get involved.
When I was little, like I think 3 years old or something, I used to dress up as a girl because it felt really normal to me. Till people started telling me that I had to dress up to my gender I was born in, to a boy then. I kept doing it in secret till it couldn't be a secret anymore. I find it hard to explain how it feels to be like this, because I was really born like this. I was really natural to me to become this. And it's hard to explain to someone who is not that I don't have a choice, that I just feel female, and there is nothing in me that once thought that I was male. I got really depressed, and I couldn't like live with the body for, you have to wait for the operation very long, and at a certain point in my life, that was the only thing keeping me alive sometimes. Because when something bad used to happen, I used to like count down in my head, still so many days till my operation, and then I couldn't start living.
Around 50% of trans persons suffer from depression, around 30% suffer from anxiety, and about 35% have suicidal ideation or have attempted suicide at some point. Transgender persons suffer a lot from everyday harassment and exclusion, and so you might think that very high rates that are present in trans persons of anxiety disorders and depression might be partly due to this omnipresent ostracism.
The most difficult part of like that reminds me that I'm not normal is dating. Dating is really hard, because at a certain point you have to tell your partner that you're transgender or was transgender. And some boys, in my case, they don't seem to like, they think it's bad and they don't want to see me then anymore. I've had that like a couple of times now. So at a certain point, I just stopped dating because that was like a trigger for me to get depressed.
The central hypothesis that we're testing is that people who are particularly vulnerable to social rejection experience will be at increased risk for continuing to suffer from mood and anxiety disorders or suicidal ideation, even after they've transitioned into their preferred gender identity. So in our new project, we will experimentally induce an experience of social rejection, an ostracism experience, and we will measure then how the heart rate is responding, how the pupil is, for example, dilating or constricting, how the sweating response is in response to this ostracism experience. So the idea is that we want to follow people up during the transition process and then after transition. We then want to ask the participants how their mental health is, how they're feeling, and then we want to see whether the variables from the experiment, such as the heart rate or the pupil dilation, can predict us the mental health state of the trans person and how well they're doing. This might be very useful for us to know because it might help us identify which particular individuals are in need of further psychological care during and after the transition.
Well, I think it's very good that there's being research done because I think there's still a lot to be learned on a scientific level.
And I also think it's very important to ask the questions to trans people themselves. What needs to be studied?
Now I see the man I always was. That to me is like priceless. So yeah, I wouldn't go back for like $1 billion.